I am Shreyas and I am in my third year of my engineering. So I have been part of Atharvit for more than a year now, and I have been working web development team for the past 6 months. So basically this is the first webinar under web development. So this webinar is all about introduction to web development, under which we are going to study about what is website, why is website required, and the most important language, that is HTML. You may or may not have studied HTML previously, but in this webinar, I'll help you out how you can use HTML to build a web page from scratch. So let's get the session started. So what is web development? The commonly asked question. Web development is a work involved in developing a website for internet or intranet. The web development procedure includes web design, web content development, either it might be client-side or server-side, scripting, network security configuration, among other tasks. Web development can range from a simple static web page, like blogs, to complex web-based applications, web apps, or social networking services. So why is web development so important? Why you should study web development? So there is a saying called as an eye is a window to a soul. A website is a window to a business. Suppose you have launched a new product, or you want to market a new product, or there is an event or activity that is taking place in your company. So you want to attract clients to a business. You must market it. So website is one of the easiest and cost effective way where you can market it. So you can either communicate with your visitors effectively, either through comment section, or you can keep in touch with the visitors. So improve your connectivity. This is you using social networking services. There are many websites that help you to connect with people all around the world. And one more thing, confirming your credibility in the global level. This is the most important aspects why you must have a website. To sum it all up, it is pretty clear that web development is a must in a business marketing. So without a study of web development or knowledge of web development, it is very difficult to leave your mark in a global level. So what are you waiting for? Use your time, start building a website, and get ready to use the benefits from website. So what does a web developer do in a regular base? So there is a phases in which a website is built. First is the planning phase, in which he plans, he collects the content which must be added to the website. Then is the building phase. This is the longest phase. And then is maintaining phase and updating phase. In these phases, web developer builds a website, web-based applications, and adds an input and output based on the client or user requirement. And he designs the layout, looks, and way the people use the site. Web development is not only about coding. A good website must be also eye-catching and appealing. A visitor must feel good when he visits a website. Even the browser should feel happy to open your website. So what is front-end development? So basically the website is divided into two main parts. One is front-end development and one is back-end development. The front-end development is also known as the client-side development, in which languages like HTML, CSS, and JavaScript for a website or web application is used. In building a website, there are web-based web development languages like HTML, CSS, JavaScript, and DOM, in which you can build a website or web-based applications. So what does a front-end developer do? So when a user clicks or something, suppose you want to search something in the browser. Here you can see a user. He wants to search something in the browser. He writes a text and clicks a search button. And when he clicks a search button, so till here it's a front end part. And then it is moved past to a back end, where it goes and searches in a database. The database is a storage device, a storage place where all the data of the website is stored. So when he searches when the search request is passed, it searches in a databases whether it is closely related to his requirement or any. So it will send a response to his request, and he can see the changes in the website. So what is backend development? This is the second major part of the website. So backend development refers to the server side of the development. It is the term used for the behind the scenes activities that will happen when performing an action or a website. Here you can see the browser. The browser is mainly a front end part. while as web server and database is the backend part. So where you can see various backend development use. In small blocks, there is no requirement of a backend part of it. While in dynamic web pages, like as news applications or weather application, where the data gets continuously updated, there is a requirement of a backend development. Now I'll give an example for why the backend is required. See, suppose there is a sign in registration process, and for the first time when you register and when you put your credentials and click a register button, all your credentials get stored in the database. And the next time when you sign up, when you click the sign in button, all the credentials gets cross-checked with the previously added details. And if there is a match, your sign in will be successful. So in this picture, you can see properly how front end is different from back end. The user can see only the front end part of the website, while the back end part he cannot see, but plays an integral role in a web development. So now let's look on some of the basic tools that is required for building a website. So first is the coding software. So these are the types of softwares that you're gonna need while building a website. There are different softwares like Visual Studio Code, Sublime Text, Atom, Notepad++, PyCharm, Brackets, WebStorm, and PHPStorm. These are the different softwares. You can try any softwares. All works the same way, but the functionality and convenience is different. So Visual Studio Code is the most used software. It is efficient, and there are many features that you might feel better than when compared to other softwares. So speaking more about VS Code software, which I'll be working on in the further slides. So Visual Studio Code is an advanced software. It is not an IDE, but it supports different languages like HTML, CSS, Python, JSON, and other languages. It has a shortcut keys and a N number of extensions which you can download and use it. So speaking about HTML is one of the most important language in web development. Without HTML knowledge, it is very difficult. It is very difficult, or it is impossible to build a website. HTML and CSS is another language that comes next to HTML, which are the building blocks of web development. Without knowing the ins and outs of HTML, it's very difficult to build a website. So it is one of the easiest programming languages. So I hope it will be easy. Now I'll be explaining HTML. What is HTML? HTML is a standard markup language for creating web pages. HTML stands for Hypertext Markup Language. It describes the structure of the web page. HTML consists of tags. It is represented by tags. It consists of elements. And HTML tells the browser how to display a content. HTML handles the markup presentation. All the text content that is there in the website are because of HTML. So what are the features of HTML? On the right hand side, you can see this is called as a syntax of HTML, also called as boilerplate. And on the left hand side, these are the keywords that you regularly come across when writing a HTML code. Let me explain you each terms. First is doctype HTML. A doctype HTML signifies three things. One is the version of the HTML that you're using, that is HTML5. And one more thing, that the code that you're writing is of a document type. And doctype HTML also helps load your website properly in the browser. Next comes the HTML tag. This is added at the beginning and the ending of the web page. Each tag has an opening and a closing tag. So this is a root tag, HTML tag. And within the HTML tag, there are two parts. Like just like a human, there is a head and a body part for a website, for a HTML syntax. Within head, there is a title. All the title of the page, even the links that are to be added are added in the head, and even the meta information. So what is meta information? Meta information is the information that is related to the code that we are writing. Either it might be even the location of the code, or such other information. And even we can add links within the head tag. Links such as for icons, for font, such links you can add, or for even for linking other pages you can add. So outside the head, there is a body. This is a bulk section where all the content of the web page is added. H1 and P tags are the two different tags that you're going to be using in the web page. So next is HTML tags. It is one of the important concepts in HTML. HTML tags are the element's name surrounded by angle brackets. So here you can see the tag name, the opening tag name, and the closing tag name. Both the tag names are required for a content within for the content to make a change within enclosed content to change. So opening tag name and closing tag name both should be same. The difference between opening and closing tag name is the forward slash. So different tag name perform different functions. So here are a few commonly used tag names. One is H1 to H6 that refers to most important heading and least important heading. It changes with the size as the number increases. And this is P tag, which symbolizes the paragraph tag. A tag symbolizes the linking tag. Image tag, which is used for adding an image. Button tag, and these are the list. Let me show you with an example. So this is the Visual Studio Code. I have already installed. You can install it from Chrome. It is a free software. All you have to do is create a new file by clicking on this icon, and you can create any file name. But the extension should be the same, HTML. And now the HTML file is created. So what one benefit of HTML Visual Studio Code is, if you write the code halfway, the next part will be there in the preset. So for example, you need to add a syntax or the boilerplate for the HTML code. Just type doc and press enter. The entire syntax of HTML has appeared. So HTML language, this is the language's attribute. This symbolizes the language is English, and the title. You can add the title as prototype. And within the body, all the contents of the web page should be added. Now let me explain you H1 tag. Just type H1 and press enter. So both the opening and the closing tag appears. This is H1 tag. In a similar way, you can add other tags. So I'll write H3 tag, I'll skip H2 tag. So H6 is the smallest tag. So now to run this in a browser, you need to install an extension. Just like a Play Store, even we have an extension store for Visual Studio Code, where you can install extensions. Click on the extension button, and you have to install Live Server. Live server, I have already installed it. This is required to open the page that you have created in the browser. Right click and open in live server. See, this is H1 tag. H1 tag is the largest. H3 tag is a bit smaller than the H1 tag, and H6 is the least. You can resize this heading just by changing the tag name. The next tag is paragraph tag. Paragraph tag is represented by P. So now you can add a text. So I'll be adding garbage text just by adding lorem. This is the garbage text where we'll get a text, a rough text, just for sample purpose. Paragraph tag. I'll make one more paragraph. See, these are the two paragraphs. I have used one paragraph tag for this and one paragraph tag for this. So it has created two different paragraphs. So next I'll be adding anchor tag, which is also called as a link tag. Anchor tag. Anchor tag has one attribute called as href. What href does is it symbolizes the, it represents the link. Whatever you want to add, suppose I want to add Amazon. Now the text that gets displayed in the browser is Amazon. So now I want to, on clicking this Amazon, it should redirect to Amazon page. So what you have to do is go to Amazon page, just copy the link and paste it within the href. So now when you click on the text, it will get redirected to the Amazon page because you have added this URL. So anchor tag is used in such a way. So next to anchor tag, there is a tag called as button tag. Button tag, the tag name itself is button. Opening and closing of a button tag You can add it as same image. I'm using the same Amazon. So now the button has appeared. It does not have any function currently. So now what you can do to click on making this on, when you click on this, it should redirect to Amazon page. So what you can do, you can use the anchor tag itself. Just by using the anchor tag within the button tag, the same text get added within the button. Now when you click this button, it will get redirected to Amazon page. This is the use of button tag and anchor tag. Next comes image tag, which is given by IMG. If you give image, it has two different attributes. One is source and one is art. What is source? You can add image in two different ways. One is from the local directory. It means if you have downloaded it from the browser, it will be in a local directory. And one is you can add directly from the browser itself. One is source. I'll add the source. If you press dot and slash, all the pages in the in your folder gets displayed here. So this webdev.png. Let me show you the image. So this is the PNG I have already downloaded and kept it in the same folder. So image source I have added. Now what is alt? Alt is the alternative text that should be visible if the if this image is not available. Now I'll save it. See, the image has loaded. So one more method how you can add images. You can add it directly from the browser without downloading. Let me show you how. So if you want to add, this is unsplash.com. This website will be very helpful when browsing for image. This is no copyright image. You can download n number of images from here. So this is the image that I want to add. I'll copy the image address directly from here without downloading it, and I'll paste it here. So what this HTML, so what the source does is it goes to the source. Okay, source, and I have added alt. I'll add it not available. So in this prototype, see the image got loaded. The next to image tag is. There are many attributes. Like now we want to set height and width of this image. So how do you set the height of it? There is an attribute called a style attribute, in which you can set the height and width. Just by style equal to height of the image. So you can add 300 pixel. So pixel is the unit in which this length is added. You can either add it in pixel, or you can add it in a percentage, or you can add it in VH. So I have set it to 300 pixels. Width to 400 pixels. So now this image, I have set the height and width. I have changed the style of height and width of this image. Now the image size has changed. The same way I can do for the other image also. Just now both the images are of same size. Now next tag I'm going to be explaining is after image tag. A button tag is done, image tag is done, paragraph tag is done, and one is list tag. If you want to list the items, for example shopping cart, all the items that you have purchased. So this is unordered list. Unordered list, if it will be shown in bullets. Ordered list, it will be shown in numbers. Unordered list, UL tag represents unordered list, and LI tag represents the list items. This is H2 tag. You know this H2 tag. This is the list items. LI tag represents list items, Sunday and Monday. UL represents unordered list. That means the list will be in bullets. If it is ordered list, then it is in 1 and 2. It is in terms of number. So what is this? So you can comment this section by pressing control and forward slash. If you press control and forward slash, this section gets commented. Once it is commented, even though the code is there, it does not get displayed in the browser. So why commenting is required? Commenting is required if the if there is some things that should be added to this code, or if the work is incomplete or the code is incomplete, or if you want to leave a message for the other developers to come and check, or if you want to set a reminder. So see, this section needs work. So this is the comment that I have left. So I can comment it. Even though this is there in the code, it does not run in the browser. So how to uncomment it? Just select the part and press again, control and forward slash. So now it is uncommented. Now it will run in the browser. So moving forward, next to HTML tags is HTML attributes. Almost all the attributes I have already explained. href is for anchor tag, which symbolizes the page or the URL link. This is the source of the image from the local directory or either from the directory from the browser. This is the width and height of the image which you can set. And this is alt. Alt of an image is alternative tag. Alternative that can be of if the image is not available. Style tag. By using style tag, you can either set height, width, you can even change the background color and even the font size. Language. Language attribute of HTML declares the language of the web page, which is by default it is set to English language. The title attribute defines some extra information about the element. Whatever the things that is added in the title, suppose if the title is document, if when it's loaded in the browser, this part is title. So next to attributes is HTML formatting elements. This is just like tag name. Even this has opening and closing tag. But if you want to edit or modify the things that you have added, you can use these tags. So commonly used is bold tag, strong tag, italic, emphasized text, mark text, small text. I'll be showing you with an example all these tags. I have used tags within tags. This is H4 tags. So within that B tag represents bold. So now this bold sentence will get highlighted. Bold. It gets strong. It's highlighted. The same way, both B tag and strong tag works the same way. It highlights. And italic and emphasized. Both works the same way. It typically makes the sentence within italic. And mark. If you want to highlight some text, the one which you do in highlight up in, you can add a mark tag which highlights the text within, and delete tag. You can take down all these tags and you can test it and use it later. Delete tag. Now, if you use a delete tag, whatever the text within, the delete tag will get a cross mark across it. So one is subscript tag and superscript tag. Sub tag and superscript tag. Suppose you want to write a H2O. When you write it as a H2O, all will be in the similar same level. So if you want to put the H2 to just bottom, you can use a subscript tag. So H will be there and 2 will be go to bottom and O will be there. And within the number within the tag gets to bottom. And the same way superscript works, but in the opposite way, it goes to the top. This is the bold and strong, which gets highlighted, and this is italic and emphasized. This is mark, just like a highlight pen. This is deleted text. And this is a subscript, and this is a superscript tag. So, adding more detailed information, that is abbreviation, address. Okay, abbreviation defines an abbreviation or an acronym. Address tag defines the contact information of an author, owner, or a document. If you want to specify your address, you can use address tag. BDO defines the text direction. The text that is added within the BDO tag, opening and closing tag, you'll get an attribute such as the direction. You'll get an attribute. So if you write it as left to right or right to left, the text within gets aligned in the right to left order or right to left order. That is the function of BDO. Next is block quote. It defines the section that is quoted from another source. You can add this quoted section from another source to this source by using block quote tag. Then comes cite tag. What the cite tag is used? It defines the title of a work. Suppose you are adding a book and you are writing the information about the book, and you want to make the name of the book a bit different from the other fonts. So you can use cite tag. So either it will be italic or you can change the font of that book name. So quoted tag. Next is quoted tag. You know the double quotes. So for to add double quotes to para to a paragraph without adding it within the quote, you can use a quoted tag so that both the opening and closing quote will be visible. Next comes HTML styles. HTML style attribute. Setting the style of an HTML element can be done with the style attribute. You might have already seen by using style attribute, you can set background color, text color, fonts, text size, and text alignment. Let me show you with an example. See, this is a style attribute which I have already used. Paragraph tab. Adding a background. Now I should add a background color to this text. So what I'll do, I'll add a style. All you have to do is adding a style. I'll select a property that is background color. These are the default colors that is available. I'll add a crimson as a background color. So now what will happen is add a background text. Behind it, there will be a color, background color of this. Add a background text. Behind that, the color that we have added. The same way you can change even the text of the this. So styling method will be the same. Just you have to do is style font family. The font weight. A font weight refers to the if you increase the font weight, the thickness of the font also will increase. This is for background. This is font size, color. There are many properties that you can add. Height, weight, everything you can set. Font. If you type the halfway, the other halfway will be in the preset of Visual Studio Code. So Visual Studio Code will help you. Font family. These are the default font families which you can use. I'll use this font. So now the font of add a background will get changed. Add a background. So these two are different fonts. The font got changed. The one more important tag is a break tag. If you add a break tag, it will skip a line. BR tag. Just adding a BR will give you a line space. Break tag. See, I have added a break tag, so the gap between this is more. It will skip a line and move the text to the next line. Moving forward, after HTML styles, you can either a text alignment. Text alignment is a property in which either the text gets aligned horizontally or the text gets aligned vertically. The text size, just like H1 tag, you can set the text size and you can change it. This is the font that I have already shown. Even the text color you can change. So defining a HTML table, you can create a HTML table and add a content to it. So within the body tag, you can add a table tag. One is opening tag and one is closing tag. Table tag. Within the table opening and closure tag, you can add the three main tags that is required. This is table row. This is each horizontal rows must be enclosed within the table row, and the table header. The heading of the table is represented by TH, and TD represents the cell contents, all the cell contents within the tag. So this is the caption tag, which represents the caption name of the table. Let me show you with an example. So this is the table that has already been have commented. So within the opening and closing tag, forward slash opening and closing tag, I have added the caption. So this is the table name. Caption is a tag for table name. This is a table row. Each individual row is represented by TR, TR, TR. So now there will be three horizontal rows. So within the table row, the table heading, TH, the table heading is month and income. So next is TD. TD represents the cell contents. This is January. Month is January and TD. Income is 1500. Open with lives over. See, the income, month and income, January, February. This is income. So you can style this using CSS by adding box to this. So these are the tags. By using tags, you can make the table in HTML itself. So moving forward, intermediate HTML. Every HTML element has a default display value depending upon what type the element it is. The two display values are block and inline. The block, if you want to add a new line, move to a new line, you can use a block value. If you want to continue in the same line, you can use an inline. One example for block values are division tag and inline tag is span tag. Division tag always begins from a new line, and it uses the entire space of the entire width of the browser. Your span tag continues with the same line, and it occupies only the width that is required. Let me show you with an example. All the things that you are going to add must be within the body opening and closing tag. Division tag. Paragraph tag. Paragraph tag. This is an important text. Now I want to be using division tag here. So this is how we use division tag. Either we can use within the tags or you can use it outside. So this is division tag, and I'll show you how to use a span tag. Span tag. See, this is an important tag. Here at the top and bottom, there is a division tag. So it uses the next line. If you want to continue in the same line, you can use a span tag. So why do we need tag when you can write a sentence on the same line? So if you want to highlight it, if you want to highlight only this tag, you can add a class to a span. Okay, you can either add a class or a style. Style to a tag. Background color, pink color. So by using span or division, you can make the changes within the text. Now only the important part is highlighted. The background color of only important within the span tag is changed. So these are the two tags in under intermediate HTML. So other two aspects, other two that is important in HTML is class attribute. HTML class attribute is used to define equal styles for elements with the same class name. So suppose there is a sentence and you want to style it, and you have to name the sentence. There is a sentence called as, this is a sentence. Now I want to give a name to this sentence. This is a tag name, right? Now I want to give a name to the sentence. I'll use division tag itself. So now I want to give it a class name. So class is equal to, you can add any name, class name. So class node. Now by calling this node in other pages, CSS pages, or even in this pages, we can style this text. So now I have given the node as a name for this sentence. So by using the same class name, you can style different elements. Even though the sentence, even though the content is different, by using the same class name, you can style it in a different way. So these sentences are different. The tags are same, but only by using the class name, similar class name, you can style them together in the same way. So class name is case sensitive. It should be the same way, and it should be the same way. So the class name can also be used by a JavaScript to perform certain tasks for elements with a specified class name. Next is the ID attribute. This is just like a class. In the similar, it works in a similar way of ID. So why is ID attribute required when there is already a class attribute which works the same way? Suppose you might have seen in a browser, at the top in the navigation bar, there are different options like about us, contact us section. There are different pages. So if you want to switch from one page to another, you can assign a separate unique ID for each pages. So that when you click on that, you can call that ID so that it will get changed to that page. So this is the function of ID. The ID value can be used by CSS. Either it can be used for styling or JavaScript to perform certain tasks for elements with a specified ID value. Even the ID value is case sensitive. So what is the difference between class and ID? The HTML element can have only one unique ID, for each page or separate containers, it can have only one unique ID, but whereas class can be used n number of times. So how to view a HTML source code? Let me show you it in the browser. So how to view a code? Suppose you want to know something from this is a website. Suppose you want to see the color of this, or if you want to see how this is done. So if you're curious how it is done, so just right click and click on inspect. If you click on inspect, you'll get a HTML code. This is the HTML part of the code where you can see the HTML part. This is a CSS part, styling part. You can change it, but it does not apply. It gets applied here, but when you close it, it gets back to the normal. And you're designing your web page in the desktop, which means the width is more. So if you want to check how your website looks in other devices, you can set a device. See, you will get a device here. You can set it to iPhone X. In iPhone X, the view will be in such a way. In Surface Duo, your view will be such a way. And you can even select a certain element. If you want to see what color is this, if you want to see what are the margin it is set, you can check it by using this function. This is for mobile function. Just by pressing inspect, or shortcut is Control Shift I. So next is HTML JavaScript. You can add JavaScript just by mentioning a script tag, just like how you can add style by mentioning a CSS by mentioning a style tag. You can add a script tag and add JavaScript. Script tag makes the HTML pages more dynamic and interactive. The common uses of JavaScript is for image manipulation, either for animation, or if you want to add a live timings, you can use JavaScript. If you're using it in a small content, you can add it in HTML page itself just by adding it within the script tag. You can either add it within the head open and close tag, or within the body open and close tag. So HTML is all about writing the content of the web page. Next is CSS. CSS is responsible for making the web page beautiful. You can add a background color, and you can align the items. You can create your own layout. You can style it. You can even add animation. So for now, in this webinar, only HTML is involved. If you want to attend even the CSS webinar, it's on December 6th. You can register it. For now, this will be the end of webinar session. Thank you. If you have any doubts, you can ask. What are the single page websites? Okay, single page websites are also called as static web pages. Suppose there is a block pages using. Okay, by using this single page static web pages, just by learning HTML and CSS, you can create a single page web pages. Single page, you might have seen blog, right? That is a single page web pages. So the next doubt is command to run code. Okay, command. There is no command to run code. When you're after writing your code, just right click and click in open with live server. Alt L or Alt O, open with live server. It gets open in the browser. Yeah, we can merge Python elements with HTML pages, just like how we can merge JavaScript with HTML. We can merge even Python. What are the free platforms that you can practice? Okay, there are many platforms where you can practice HTML. One is W3 Schools, where you will get a much knowledge, much more about information about HTML, CSS. Platform where you can practice. Okay, even in SoloLearn, you will get a playground where you can try different types of code and test it. Covering backend and frontend development part. Yes, we'll be covering frontend and backend development in future session. This was all about HTML. Next session is CSS, and further session will be regarding backend. Can you again explain clearly how Amazon website using HTML? Yeah, I'll explain how Amazon website. See, There are different function for tags. Suppose what if you can't run a paragraph just by using a paragraph tag, you can't run you can't use a URL to redirect to other browser. You must use a tag called as a tag. A is the anchor tag. Href symbolizes the URL that you should add. So now all you have to do is go to a browser and copy the link. So this is the URL. You have to copy the URL and you have to paste it within the href tag. So now now this is redirected. Amazon. Now when you click the Amazon text, it redirects to this site or URL. I added one more button. Now when you click on this, it will redirect to Amazon web page. I hope this doubt is clear. Names and links. Yeah, I'll drop the names and links of the tags that is used. Yeah, in the future webinars, we'll plan on doing this data transaction web pages and webinar that is based on IoT service. For practicing it out. What is this for practicing out? For practicing the code. You can either use a SolarLearn playground for practicing the code, or you can download a software, so this software, Visual Studio Code, and practice software. And you can either refer a complete build website, building of a web page from either from a YouTube, and you can learn it just for beginner. Backend and front end in the webinar. Okay, so the JavaScript framework that we are going to be using is React.js. So there are two, the React.js and Angular.js. So which we are going to be using is React.js, and backend framework will be Node.js that we are going to be using. Yeah, this recording will be added in the YouTube. You can check it. So where we can register for CSS webinar, the link will be put up soon for the next webinar, which is on December 6th. I hope you understood and liked it. Thank you.